Oh crap, it shrinks it down. Okay, we gotta close those windows.
No. No, it's my... Oh crap.
What is it?
I gotta just adjust the light while it's still on. What the hell? So...
Yeah, let's just do that. Let's just do this thing. Walking down the street.
You guys, we're catching the very last bit of daylight. I can't even see.
You look good.
Yeah, but my glasses are so dirty. I can't even see myself on the screen.
So we are in...
We're catching the very last of our daylight. We need to preface that. We're doing a little update video.
So we did an update on, basically an update on the home, staying at home isolation thing a couple weeks ago. We just got some big news again today about where we're at in the state of Washington. There's been a lot of updates both with our business here at home with homeschooling. So we just want to go through that and update you guys, let you know where we're at. We really enjoyed the comments last time telling us about what's going on where you are. Has it gotten tighter? Has it gotten looser? What's going
on? All of our friends in Europe, they're ahead of us. Totally. They're on stricter lockdowns. Mm-hmm. And then as we go across the United States East, they're slowly catching up to us. Some places are actually stronger than us because like New York, they have higher
densities. On the coasts, and it's just working its way in.
Yeah.
And we're all doing it state by state rather than the whole country like some of you other countries.
And I'm gonna preface this. We don't want, this isn't a doom and gloom video. It's mainly to just update our status. And for us to like, we tell our kids every single day, you will be able to tell your kids about this when you get older, and you'll have all of these videos to document what your life looked like during all of this. And so part of what the reason we're documenting this is for our own posterity, for our own kids and grandkids and great-grandkids to understand what we were doing, where we were at, you know, what are the changes that are occurring, and they're literally happening
day
like
by day.
Multiple things happened just today alone where we haven't really had any drastic changes for a good 2 weeks.
It stayed kind of stable for 2 weeks, and so the big announcement is that the governor
of Washington
announced that we are going to stay on lockdown until May 2nd, which is
fourth. Sorry, dude.
It doesn't matter. Second, fourth.
May 4th. It's all just a, for whatever reason in his head.
No, I knew it was a pipe dream. So the other front we have is basically the business. The business has been closed since March 16th.
We have a shoe store, in case you're new.
Yeah, I had to tell my employees they need to go file for unemployment, which is heart-wrenching after 17 years of being in business and good people.
Yeah.
We had a new guy, whatever, that really sucks as a business owner. And we've been shut, very little to no business since. As many other small businesses in America, at least, we are scrambling to figure out
what to do.
I'm trying to think of the non-swear words to come to.
There's not too many of those.
There's some, you know, relief or whatever, except the rules, the information changes daily. Mm-hmm. I've been to the bank 3 times. They have no clue. They're to the point where they're not even setting appointments for Friday because they have no idea what they're supposed to tell people.
Okay, so in general...
Well, that's what I'm dealing with the business.
Right, in general, we've applied for an immediate...
Lots of different programs, and we're going to try to... We're going to bum rush all the financial institutions along with 8 million plus other businesses that are going to try to get some chunk of this money. And it starts.
I'm gonna bring him down a notch because he's starting to.
Well, this is the truth.
I know it's the truth. I know, but you're escalating your adrenaline.
No, I'm
is
done.
Like
that's it. That's why I know. I'm bum rushed. So that's what we're doing now. Let's go back to cheery teaching.
No, I'm not talking about how cheery and wonderful this is. I just know you're escalating your anxiety level with the conversation, and I don't want to do that here on this channel. I want to explain where we're at and what we're doing. We have the potential of doing SBA loans with the banks coming this Friday, which is tomorrow. We don't know what that looks like. Banks don't know what
Nobody
that looks
knows,
like. No one really knows what that looks like. We're going to work through the process the best we can.
I spent a week and a half doing it online, and then they closed the portal.
Okay, so we've also tried to get, we have done an application for an immediate grant, if you want to call it that, for sake of we don't know what the word is, money to come in immediately to help the business. We will get stipend money from the government in the next coming weeks. We have automatic deposits set up with our taxes, so yeah, that will come quicker than if you happen to receive a check.
That's going to everybody, apparently, yeah.
So we have some relief, both personally and business, professionally, in sight. It's not secured, it's not, we don't know when it's coming,
it's
but
here.
It is, it's, I know. That's where we're at with that. And then also, despite our prank on the kids yesterday, if you watched that video, I will link it right here. We pranked the kids yesterday that they would have to repeat their school year next year. And today, kind of wondering if that's, no, it's not gonna be the case. With this new change of May 4th that the governor just announced today, the district that our kids go to also sent out a message. And just to backtrack, our district so far has been what they've called continuous learning, in terms of the information coming home from teachers and their staff in what curriculum they give to these students, whether it's K through 5, middle school, or in high school. And we have kids in all three schools. And so they've just been in this loop of relearning,
reviewing
the current information that they already were working on. Starting after our spring break, which actually technically starts next week. Is that correct?
Whatever, I have no clue.
Okay, so our spring break technically starts in like a week. And so after our spring break, in 2 weeks, they are working on doing a curriculum, and I forget what their word is, with new information.
Learning new stuff.
So they're going to go to core requirements within each subject. Core information to advance to the next grade next year. That is their ultimate goal, is to make sure they know enough math to get to fifth grade math for like our Chelsea. And knowing Kaylee's in Algebra 1, can she advance next year to Algebra 2 based on the information she is going to get from now until the end of the year? So that's their main requirement. They don't know what that looks like. They're working on that.
And so the homeschool aspect of all this is definitely gonna change.
We've
been doing pretty good. It's easier with the younger kids.
It's easier with the younger kids, and one of our kids is easier because she has self-motivation. The other one, it's not required mentality, is going to change because that information is going to be new. And whether they are graded or we're going to go on a pass-fail basis, which is what they're going to look into within our state and probably around the world, it still needs to be learned. And so whether you're getting tested on it, whether it's turned in, you still need to learn that information. So that will change in a mild way for one of our kids.
This time at homeschooling stuff.
Yeah, it's going well.
It's done pretty good. We have some laptops and iPads.
Yeah.
I know some other friends of ours, they've been given some little PC tablets.
Chromebooks and tablets.
And it's driving them crazy because nothing works. And
yeah, you know, so it's not all peachy keen.
It's tough.
Yeah. So our kids are doing well with it. We feel like we can move forward with a new curriculum if they advance that to us. In that way, they're all doing okay. They're all, you know,
they're doing what we can.
Doing what they can in their own way.
I'm sure there's some people killing it with the homeschool thing, but we're just doing probably average.
And we had our first homeschool video go up, and he's like, oh, there's a lot of attention going to that video. And I was like, no, there's a lot of attention because they think that I'm a homeschooler because that's what I'm tagging it at. And they're realizing, oh, she doesn't know a thing about what she's doing. So the retention on that video is like 10%.
The other thing is the projects we're getting done around the house. Yeah. I just cleaned a bunch of the blinds. I'm going to do more upstairs.
Yeah.
Tried to fix a gap above the garage with some insulation, but we need weather stripping, but I'm not gonna go buy that right now because—
Yeah, the problem is that like, there are things that I want to do. Like I would love to like take this time to paint, but I don't, one, wanna spend the money on the paint, and I don't know, is Lowe's and Home Depot open?
Yeah, because contractors are essential.
But I'm trying to not go to stores that I don't absolutely need to go to. And so, and I don't wanna say, yeah, I don't wanna spend the money. If, yes, I would love to have my house painted, we have the time, but do I need that $50 to pay for groceries if we don't?
I would actually do it because I'm going to be, I'll admit, we can do a video here at the end of May and compare it, but I'm going to be poor off my freaking head.
Stop. We are going to be pretty.
I'm going for some like solo hikes in the middle of nowhere or something. I mean, I can't do this.
It's hard. Part of the reason why it's taken us a couple days to film this and why we kind of scrambled to record this video right now at the very end of our day, it's actually Ashley's birthday today, so we should be doing her cake and celebrating the last of her birthday with her, but morale is hard to keep up within the home. And so while we've tried to film this video like 3 different days, it's not easy when you're stressed. And I didn't ever want to bring that to the video because I although that's a reality of our life, it's really hard to then argue with each other or with us too or with a kid because they don't quite understand. It's hard to then turn this camera on. And I can do that during our daily stuff because I just decide not to turn on the camera for a couple hours and I can pick up later when we're in better moods and we're playing games and we're having fun. But we haven't filmed this video because it's hard. And
we don't want to be a negative channel, and we understand. Yeah. We also don't want to paper code it. But yeah. I mean, I joke around with my other business relationships and stuff that in 9 months, there's going to be a lot more children and a lot more divorces. This yeah. Like, this is not the easiest thing to do.
Yeah.
We all love each other, but we're not meant to be this close to each other. And I'm sure it's the same for you guys.
Yeah.
But
let us know in a couple months if you're pregnant.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
But
not happening here. We can link that video down below on why that won't happen.
Yeah.
The people that are watching, they know.
They know. That is not happening. At the same time, you know, it was interesting because I was having conversations with my family this weekend and, you know, my mom was watching the videos and she said, oh, I just thought everything was fine. And I watched, you know, and everything seemed fine. And while we want to portray that we are fine, I also don't want to portray a sense of
that our
unreality.
Business isn't shut down, that we're not like freaking
right.
Panicked on what the future is going to hold, and that we're not sitting here crammed in our house for 2.5 months.
Yeah, it's not easy. And yes, everyone jokes around wearing pajamas every single day. And you know, this is as dressed up as I get on top. Like, but
she is wearing pants, by the way, which is
I great. Am wearing pants, but I'm rotating through the same like 4 pairs of sweatpants.
Yeah, but be comfortable, be comfortable.
So if you watch our daily videos, which we welcome you to watch them if you are new and just coming from for this video and update, we do try and see the positive within our videos themselves and with our kids. We try to listen to them when they say, you know, we need to go for a drive. We actually kind of drop things and go for a drive because that's what they're telling us. Their stress level is high and they need to get out. So we go for a drive, whether that's for 10 minutes to go get a drink or for an hour and a half and we don't know where we are gonna end up. We try and listen to those things with our kids, but we're not going to lie and pretend like this isn't hard. It's very difficult. And
I'm sure it is, all you yeah. guys understand. I mean,
yeah, you all understand.
You're going through it, trying to get your kids to focus,
yeah.
keep some structure and just
Or you're not, or you're
other.
Older and it's just you and your husband or you yeah. and your spouse or you're by yourself. I mean,
this is like retirement. You know, when people retire, then they sit there and like, holy crap, now what do I do?
I think this is a good test if we can actually handle retirement, if we
so.
Can be around each
yeah.
other all the time. I saw a meme on that
yeah,
today.
Yeah, no, it's the way it goes. It's like, yeah. then they're like, holy crap, you know, and we're being forced to do that plus homeschool. It's like I had a conference call this morning, kind of impromptu. We needed to do it with the other owners.
But it smacked
up. But it interfered
up.
With Ashley's birthday, so I got off the conference call as quick as I could.
Yeah. I mean, it's hard because he had his conference call and she wanted open presents and we needed to rush to get our breakfast and lunches from the bus stop from the school. And it literally all happened in the same half hour time frame. And that's hard to like,
and there's things I mean, I have to do
bucket.
To try to fill the stress of trying to figure out business and manage all this other stuff and then jump to doing homeschool after my conference call. It's just a lot to juggle, as I know
yeah.
you all are. That's why we want your comments below, because if we all get talking about it, knowing that other people are going through the same thing helps.
Yeah.
And tips. So please, if you've never commented before on anything, just leave a little comment. It can be small, it can be big. Other people, not just us, will like to watch it, read it. Please leave comments.
Well, and it's interesting in the conversations that I've had lately, whether it was family or friends or what, or that I've viewed from online, people were like, oh, I thought you were fine. Or I thought you were, you know, had a job, husband who has a job that paying him still to work from home. We all have our own struggles in this. And sometimes it's not like someone saying, oh, well, I can give you this and I can give you that if you need help financially. Sometimes it's not even that. It's just someone to listen or someone to like just say what we're going through. And then once you've said it, you're better. And someone can listen to that and sympathize. And so not only do we need that from our own family members within our own home and with our extended family and our parents and beyond that, it's actually extended to you guys too. You guys can do that to us. Like if you need that person to listen to you in that way, we're here because we're literally
we've
all
got
doing,
else to
we've
do.
Got nothing else to do. So we might as well answer questions. We might as well put out there for activities to do. Like I love that people love that I took my kids to the cemetery to watch a movie. And that was one more idea of what they could do with their kids, because we all need new ideas of what we can do from our home and from our car. That's our reality right now. So if we can all help each other, then we're just a little bit better off on a day-to-day basis. Because
yeah.
we're literally at a day-to-day basis here.
Misery loves company.
Yeah. In terms of, I'm not going to give specific details, in terms of our vacation that we had planned for a week and a half from now, we were going to go to Maui, Hawaii.
Still technically can.
Still technically can. We still have it pre-booked at a further date. We have not repurchased our airfare. For our airfare, we were given credits with two different airlines that we purchased our tickets with initially.
So we're still holding out.
Hawaii itself is going to flatline in terms of their curve really quick.
They've done a good job.
They're really doing a good job. My cousins live on the island of Oahu, and she's already like deeming that she's not going to go back to school as a teacher. She's like, I'm already planning on that.
They've done a good job in Hawaii. The question is whether they'll want outsiders to come in.
Right.
Which is Hong Kong and these other places that were doing good, but then they opened up. So we'll see.
We'll see. We have a date set. If we can't go for that,
we're screwed.
No, we're not technically. The owner of the Vrbo unit that we are renting from has extended the credit through the rest of this year. I'm just gonna say that. It's up until December 15th. We have that option. For us, in our family, we have a lot of restrictions for when he has the dates available for the unit between now and the end of the year, which make it extremely difficult for us to actually make it work.
Yeah,
so we would.
I call it screwed.
He does. He's the pessimist, and I'm trying to be the optimist. This is how our marriage works.
So, anyways, that's
the status of that. So, if we have the chance to go, we're gonna go. If Hawaii is allowing us to travel and come, we're going to come. We're not going to just go and be in quarantine in our hotel room.
No, I mean,
that's the status right now for Hawaii.
Yeah, you don't get on a cruise ship just sit in your room the entire time. So, we're not gonna go to Hawaii just to sit in a room.
Right.
Yeah, it's not.
We will only go if they allow us to come.
Yeah.
So,
and we, you know, we don't want to harm the island or anything like that, but we're in quarantine. So we'll see how that goes.
Yeah.
Like I said, so business, family, future ideas. Hey, what are you guys hoping you can do besides get off your couch and go to your kitchen and eat more crap?
In some ways, this is good that it's springtime because it's still raining a lot here in Seattle, which is normal. And it's easier to say we can't go outside and go do things with our kids because it's rainy and miserable and cold and it's 42 degrees all day long. But it's gonna get harder as we get better and better weather.
Maybe I shouldn't shave the entire time.
Go for it, but you gotta keep that you gotta just leave it here.
I really only grow right here. I can't, the sides just don't really come in. But
I don't mind it. I think it's really, really
how many weeks left? Anyways, we appreciate you watching. Please let us know how you're doing, what's working, what's not working. We already know that some of you, like the police will literally arrest you if you're doing the wrong things in your
community. Which I think is amazing.
I mean, it's cool.
I honestly do.
Those are other countries.
It's not happening here.
And how's your homeschool going or not going? What plans have you had to abandon or you're still clinging to like us?
And I'm only clinging to that because we've already paid for it. I don't want anyone to think that we're still in this because
we already paid the money.
We already paid the money and yes, we know
we can't get it back.
Well, let me explain. We're in a bad situation financially right now if our business doesn't open up back up. I don't want anyone to think that we're taking current cash away from our future ability to support our family. This trip is already paid for and it's money that we will lose if we don't end up being able to go.
Yeah.
So that being said, we want to take the opportunity to go if we get the chance to.
Mm-hmm.
We're not taking cash away from our current situation. Even money for food. I literally have my Costco rebate that I will spend money for food. So I already have all the money already spent.
Not that I care what people would think about it, but you're right. They're
not
your cause.
It's a natural
like,
curiosity.
Like, oh, they're doing a big trip and yet they're losing their business.
Yeah.
It's because we spent it in December before all this happened. And we can't get it back, so hey, we might as well go because it's already spent.
We will get back the flights. We still have a potential, but I don't wanna lose hope that we can go, but I'm not being unrealistic in the thought of it being canceled.
What else? I think that's it. I think that's our life under quarantine.
That's everything.
All right, so we will update you if anything else changes. If we get good news that we're kind of coming out of this, it literally could change in a couple days or in a couple weeks. So we'll do a separate update video, but do come and watch our daily videos because you'll get little snippets of little things that might change or just our regular day-to-day here at home.
Yeah, so, watch our daily stuff. We'll be doing normal life. Like I said, we're not going to be spending money doing projects.
No.
But we might have some little craft projects that you do, or I don't know. We'll see. Keep watching, and we'll see what happens.
Yep.
Hope you guys are doing well. Stay healthy.
Take care, you guys. Bye.
Slow-mo of us trying to get off the bed.